So we've been talking about retro video games all summer. Who has heard of the game or even played the game?
Dig
Dug. Dig Dug. Was your mom good at it? My mom was really good at it. Does we have any live action or just a picture?
Just a picture.
Just a picture. Alright, what's the object? Who knows what you have to do in that game? That's not an adult.
I don't know.
We have to do it. Aston, you were here Thursday. So you heard. What do you have to do? Now we will not be making random objects explode. Actually, we will. It's not a random object, but I do need two, a boy and a girl, preferably. Did you play on Thursday?
We all did.
Oh, everyone. We just did boys versus girls.
Yeah.
Well, that's a good idea. I like that. All right, boys versus girls. Okay. Here's the name of the game. Jeremy, you want to help me out?
Yes, I do.
Jeremy's going to be our dig dugger. Alright, we have some balloons. Oh, we didn't need that. Oh, this looks like a new announcement.
So terrible.
It ain't as bad as cheese in my bedroom.
That's just weird, Cole.
Caleb.
Alright. Here's the name of the game. We have three balloons. Listen up, gentlemen and ladies. You have to guess how many pumps it will take to not blow up the balloon. Make it pop. So like, for example, if you think this balloon will pop with two pumps, you would say, I think it's going to pop with two pumps. That makes sense? Makes sense?
If it doesn't pop, you get it wrong.
Yeah. No, if it does pop, you get it wrong. That whole gentleman's thing.
Got it.
Alright, so the object is to guess the number of pumps closest to the number that makes it pop without getting there. So if it pops in three pops.
So don't be right.
Choose one.
Yeah, don't be right. You want to be close to be the right. Alright, so we'll start We'll start with the smallest balloon.
Oh.
You guys want to mix, get with your respective gamers, you can.
One pump.
Alright, ladies, how many pumps, ladies?
Two.
Gentlemen, how many pumps?
Three.
Six pumps.
Three.
Five.
What is it?
One.
Six.
No,
five is too much.
You guys talking about
it? Four. You're going to go with
three.
Six. What's the note from the guys?
Three.
Take one in the middle.
Three.
Ladies, we have two. Are we satisfied with two ladies?
Three. Yeah.
Three. We both go with three? We both can go three.
One, two,
back to two, ladies?
One, yes.
The guys
it's
higher. Three.
I'm telling y'all, girlies.
It's higher. Right.
Here we go.
Five.
And seven.
You might want to cover your ears.
Oh, yeah, cover your ears. Thank you, Isaac. I heard it's really loud in here.
Yeah.
Here we go. What?
Ah!
One, two.
Thank you.
nothing? All right.
$1, Bob.
Hey,
$1.
What do we got?
$1.
7 and 6.
Seven.
Yes, 7.
Take your license, 9 and 7. Here we go. 1.
Nobody.
This round. 2.
Oh, that's going to be way more.
3. This is going to be a 10 or 15.
4.
5. 6. Once my fingernails are really sharp, 7. Hey, new guesses, real quick.
All right, I'm going to pray for Isaac, and he's going to bring the message on What are we talking about again?
Gentleness.
You chase them.
Sorry.
That's okay, Chase. Good job.
Alright, you're talking about
us. Father God, thank you, guys. Father God, thank you for today, God. I just ask that as Isaac prepares for this message, as you speak to him, the kids hear it, God, and that they apply this message and all the other fruit of the Spirit we've been talking about this summer. So, God, just open their ears and their hearts as Isaac brings this word. In the name of Christ.
Amen. So, there's a lot of you in here. There was not this many Thursday. My name is Isaac. I am a sophomore at Brayman High School. I play soccer for the high school. I'm trying to think of what else. I intern at the church for Mr. Corey. Mr. Corey's my boss. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm 15, so I can drive a little bit.
You don't look like it.
What?
You say you don't look like it.
Like you can even drive a car.
I can drive a car.
I think you can drive your car from your house to Walmart without crashing.
I drove it from here to City Station. I drove it from here to my house.
Here to City Station. That's a long way.
Yeah, I know, Joker. Thank you. Thank you for pointing it out. That's my dad.
What?
My sister's Isabel. She was in here, but now she's too old.
She's 8 days.
She's with Tucker now. So yeah, as Tyler said, we're talking about gentleness today. And one of the things that made me think of gentleness was there's some times when I'm feeling kind of sad, and I wanted to be cheered up. And so I'll look at these memes sometimes, and I think they'll be on the screen. Here's the first one. Alright, what's the next one?
No way. Oh my gosh, that is so.
Alright, what's the next one?
You have everything.
Is that an actual flower or is that like a headband?
Benji?
Benji!
I know!
That's what I'm thinking.
Those are pretty cool. I like those. What was your favorite one? Anybody got a favorite one?
The dog flower.
The dog
flower? I think it was the cat one. I don't
know. Anybody else have a favorite? What's your favorite?
I like the cat one. The cat.
The cat. Like, those were pretty cool, right? I like those. But what if the word stays the same, and the main thing in the picture stays the same, but it changes just a little bit? Put up the other one, the first one. Oh, no, the other first one. The sixth one. There you go. Is that as funny as the first one?
No. He looks like Dr. Phil.
What about the second one? What about the third one? Okay, there's the dog again. He doesn't even have a headband on. Kitten popping the bubbles, and then the old guy. So it's easy to be gentle with, like, if you put the cat up again, how it's so, like, cute and stuff, and, like, it's just being gentle and bright and what it does. But, like, if you have a guy doing it, you're not going to be, like, that's not really cute. A person that's going to talk about. But, like, it's easy to be gentle with, like, our pets and cats and stuff like that. But it gets a little bit more difficult when we talk about our family and our friends and stuff. I have a picture. This is my cousin Bennett when he was born. He's two now, two and a half. And this is him now, or this was him at Christmas. And he, on Monday, so she'll be a week old tomorrow, he got a baby sister named Emily. And that's, I don't have the video, but there was a video of him meeting her for the first time. And he was not, he didn't want to touch her because he was so nervous that he was going to hurt her. Or he said break her, but he's not going to break her. But he was, that's what, I thought it was cool how I was talking about gentleness this week, and he was being very gentle with his sister. And so, like I said earlier, it's hard to be gentle with our family and friends and stuff because, like, any of y'all have siblings? I have siblings.
Six.
Aspen, you have a lot of siblings.
I have nine.
I have 21.
You have 21?
No.
I don't think so.
No one has two.
You know how many siblings are.
Yeah, I know. But to answer the question about being gentle with family and friends, we're going to go to one of the Gospels in the Bible. Does anybody know all four of the Gospels? What?
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Yep. So today we're going to be reading from Mark, which is the second one. Mark 10, chapter 10. And it's talking about, it's going to be talking about Jesus and some kids, that some children that have come up to him. But one thing we learned from the Bible is that Jesus was always busy. He always had people wanted him to do miracles and bless people and bring them back from the dead and all this different stuff and heal them when they're sick. And so Jesus, I think his disciples, anybody know how many disciples he had?
12.
I feel like his disciples thought that maybe they were like bodyguards most of the time because they were trying to keep people away and they were trying to give Jesus some space. But let's think about for a second, how important are like little kids nowadays? Like they get a lot of stuff. Yeah. Like they'll get like, what are some things that little kids get?
Attention.
My brother got this like Metroid by the time he was like 5.
What about birthday parties?
Some kids get phones that
I'm thinking more like 3-year-olds, 4-year-olds. What do they get?
They get those tiny Lamborghinis.
I don't know about that, but they get like, they get all kinds of stuff. They get birthday parties and all this stuff. And people really value their kids. Like you'll see, they take a lot of care of little kids, like because they don't know as much as like we do, because they'll be running around and then they could. A lot of times you'll see them walking on the side of the road, holding mom's hand, because otherwise they're gonna run out into the street, and that would not be good. But when Jesus was on earth, kids were not that important. In fact, everybody was identified as. They were valued by how much they could give to society. And so, like, a farmer, when he grows plants and he can give a lot of plants to everybody, he was highly valued. And so now when kids are valued, they can't, in the Bible, they could not really give that much. And so they were not treated as the highest people. And so I'm going to read from Mark. This is my whole mark because I had to improvise. Chapter 10, verses 13 through 16. I'm just going to start with verse 13. It says, the people were bringing little children to Jesus. They wanted him to place his hands on them and bless them. But the disciples told him no. Now, What happened to the kids in this verse?
Anybody know?
What were they trying to do?
Meet Jesus.
They were. And they were trying to do like everybody else, just like receive blessings and stuff. But the disciples stopped them. Why do you think the disciples stopped them?
Because one of them might try to like hurt Jesus.
Well,
maybe just a baby just
It was probably, yeah, that's what it was. It was probably, the disciples probably thought he was too busy to have time for little kids that weren't as valued as other people. And so, and then the next verse, when Jesus saw this, he was very angry. There's not a lot of times where Jesus is angry in the Bible, but when he is, it's usually important. Does anybody know when else Jesus was angry in the Bible? Another example?
When all the merchants were in the temple?
That's right. When they were in the temple selling, they were basically selling all their animals and stuff in the temple. And Jesus came in and he started flipping tables and chasing the animals out. And he was very mad that people had taken God's temple and turned it into a marketplace. But Jesus is always angry when someone is being treated unfairly. So in that case, God was not being taken, his temple was not being holy and taken seriously. And in this instance, the children are not being treated fairly. But I'm going to read the rest of the passage. When Jesus saw this, he was very angry. He said to his disciples, "Let the little children come to me. Don't keep them away. God's kingdom belongs to people like them. What I'm about to tell you is true. Anyone who will not receive God's kingdom like a little child will never enter it." Then he took Jesus in his arms and he placed his hands on them and blessed them. And so, a lot of people think that like gentleness is a weakness. Like, I know for guys, like, you want to be tough and rough and run around and wrestle. And you want to just be rough and go around and, like, I don't know, like, playing football and all this stuff. And it's really hard for guys to be gentle. I don't know about girls. I'm not a girl. But it's really hard for us to be gentle, because a lot of people will think it's a weakness. But it's actually, it comes from the Holy Spirit. And it's really a power and a fruit that we can produce. I got a few examples. I know I already said this, but who has siblings? I have a sister. She's younger than me. And when she was little, her thing was, she would come in my room, and this is the door frame, she'd come in and just stand there and smile. Because she knew, you know, on my nerves that she was in my room. And she would just walk in, and I'd get so frustrated, because it wasn't that she was doing anything, it was just her standing there, and she knew that's what it was.
That's me with my brother, except you don't have a brother.
And so, instead of getting frustrated, it's good for us in circumstances like that to be gentle and just be like, hey, do you mind stepping out of my room, or do you mind going and doing something else? And also, another example is, I know my thing at the house is, I do dishes, and we kind of rotate that between me and my sister, but there will be times when I'm sitting on my couch, and my mom will come in and she'll be like, hey, the dishes need to be done, there's dishes in the sink, and I'll be like, okay, I'll do them in a minute. And then I'm still on my phone 15 minutes later, and she comes in and she says, Isaac, the dishes are still in there. And then I'll be like, oh, okay. But what I should have done in that instance is not, usually the second time I'll get defensive and get upset, but I can avoid that by just doing it the first time, and that's the way I can be gentle.
Yeah.
Another example is, how many people play sports in here? What are some of the sports y'all play?
Lacrosse,
soccer,
football.
Soccer,
football.
I used to play flag football, but
it's
football.
What do you play?
Soccer.
Soccer, what do you play? Track?
Like,
football. What do you play?
Softball.
Taylor? What do you play? Football? What do you play? Water ski?
Play cornhole.
Maybe you're really good at sports, and you can just, in PE class or something, maybe you go and say you're good at basketball, and you like to go play basketball in the gym, and there's one kid that may not be as good as you. Maybe one thing you can do is not necessarily go your best and try to make them look bad, but maybe actually let them have a turn at trying to just play well.
Teach him how to play basketball.
You could teach him how to play basketball.
Get a ball, throw it on the ground.
Another example is maybe there's a kid in your class or older than you that just he makes you so angry because he'll tease you and you just want to get back at him. Instead of getting back at him, you can show gentleness. I know there's people that I've seen that if people walk up to them and start teasing them and it doesn't bother them and they're just gentle instead of getting angry, a lot of times it's either going to stop or they're going to be curious why you're not angry. And so that's one of the things that, those are some examples of how you can be gentle. Thankfully, you don't have to be gentle on your own. There's the Holy Spirit that'll help you, and it empowers us to just show gentleness to everybody around us. But it's also good to know where you struggle so that you can pray over it and just have more control over this is where I struggle and I need to get better at this. Think about this slide right here, this question. Why is it sometimes hard to be gentle? Anybody got any answers? Why?
I get frustrated
because I'm
too much.
Yeah, that's a good one. What about you, Taylor?
Because
you're annoyed. Anybody else, Tyler?
I'm annoyed.